God bless you, my beloved. Thank you for being with us today. We are Abundant Grace Church. I'm Bishop Ramon DeMaria, and I'm the senior pastor of the church. For prayer or information concerning our church and outreach ministry, or to donate to this ministry, please email me at abundant.grace@att.net. Our message title today is Joy and Salvation. Our scripture will be from the book of Psalms, number 51, and verse 12, which reads, "Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with your generous spirit." My beloved, first of all, have you ever noticed how difficult it is to maintain eye contact with someone, especially with someone that you don't know? Or maybe we find this so difficult because it feels so intimate. Some have said that the eye is the window of the soul. So perhaps when someone gazes into your eyes, we feel vulnerable, as if that person can see all of our deepest thoughts and secrets. And perhaps that's why when we fall into sin, we can't maintain eye contact with others, fearing they can see the sin in our eyes. My beloved, sin clouds our souls, and we lose our inner sparkle. So now let's consider King David, when he had been a derelict in his duty. He had failed to go with his army into battle. In his idleness, he walked atop his palace and happened across Bathsheba, and she was bathing. He was enticed by her beauty, and he lured her to the palace and committed adultery with her. In an attempt to cover his sin, he compounded it by having her husband murdered. This was cold-blooded murder. David had now committed two grievous sins, of which the Old Testament provided no forgiveness. The king was crushed by his sinfulness. So for 1 year, all of the joy went out of him. All of the light left him. And the sparkle that he had in his life as being king, called by God, ruling over all Israel, disappeared from his soul and his eyes. My beloved, when we are deep in sin, different things happen to us. Our conscience comes against us. Our feelings come against us. And here we see that David felt as though the very bones of his body were crushed under the weight of his guilt. Never forget that Satan uses these things to badger us, to pound us every day. And until we repent and ask for forgiveness and turn our life around, Satan will come after us every waking minute of the day. So there's no doubt about it. King David was great in this act of sin. But my beloved, he was also great in repentance. And for that reason, the scriptures call him a man after God's own heart. When God convicted David of his transgressions, David said, "Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according unto the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgressions." David wouldn't let sinfulness keep him away from his Lord any longer. My beloved, just think about this for a moment. We are all sinners. Many times we commit sin over and over and over and over again. And as long as we are in this body, the sinful flesh, we will continue to commit sin. Even as Christians, we commit sin. A lot of times, Christians call it falling short of the mark. And that is true. But that hides the fact that it is downright sinfulness. But one thing that David had, that we should have, and that is we should have true sorrow for our sins. And we are to turn from our sinfulness, as King David did. My beloved, let me encourage you today to confess your sins to God and repent of anything that comes between you and God. And in doing so, he will restore the light of your soul, the sparkle in your life, and he will grant you once again the joy of your salvation. Remember the hymn, "What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus." Let us pray. Father God, in Jesus' name, there are those that have lost the joy of their salvation because of some type of sin. But Lord, we know that you are able to forgive their sin if they acknowledge their sin, repent of that sin, and turn from that sin. All of us have something that we have done wrong, and you have forgiven us. So we pray for those that are feeling guilty about their sin, that they confess that sin, lay it at the foot of the cross, and continue to go on and be restored of the joy and their salvation. Thank you, Father God, for this time of prayer, and we pray in the name of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ for all of those that need to have the joy of their salvation restored in them and the joy of serving God through Jesus Christ. And we pray this in Jesus' precious name. Amen. My beloved, go out today and tell others about Jesus Christ and what he did on Calvary for the forgiveness of the sins of all mankind, and walk in the joy of your salvation. God bless you and go with God.